Hey guys, and welcome back to another quick video. As my intro has always shown, I do want this channel to feature content that's just besides gaming. You know, gaming's always going to be a focus and something I really do enjoy, but as the intro even suggests, there are other things I wanted to feature on the channel from time to time, one of which is beer, and I'm very excited to say that my friend and I, after many, many years of trying, finally secured tickets to Dark Lord Day this past Saturday. Dark Lord Day is an event hosted by Three Floyds Brewing, out in Indiana, where they release Dark Lord, one of their most popular beers, once a year, and also have a music festival the same day. My friend and I have tried for years to get these tickets, always unsuccessfully, but we finally did get them this past Saturday. We'll be going out May 19th to pick up Dark Lord. Tickets are $180 a piece, which is steep, but you get four bottles of Dark Lord and one additional bottle of a variant of Dark Lord, you know, aged in some special type of barrel. And we're incredibly excited. You know, it's been very hard to get in years past. We've waited in queues for 30, 45 minutes with no success getting tickets. Finally just got lucky this year and got them. So we'll be flying out there. The brewery is relatively close to Chicago, so we'll probably make a weekend trip of it and check out Chicago, you know, on that same trip. But yeah, incredibly stoked for that. I thought, sort of in line with having gotten those tickets and being excited about going to Dark Lord Day, I'd quickly just show off the bottles of some of my favorite beers that I keep on a little stand, you know, near my bed, just because it's something I do enjoy and thought it might give you a little bit of insight into the beers I like. So without further ado, here they are. So the bottles that are up here aren't all my favorite beers ever. They're just bottles I chose to keep for one reason or another. For the most part, just because they are beers I really enjoy, but some I just kept for commemorative purposes or because I particularly liked the bottle. That's the case with this first beer by Amagong, this Game of Thrones, Valar Morghulis. Good beer, good double ale, but really just kept it because the bottle was cool. I got it as a gift and thought, you know, as a Game of Thrones type thing, I'd keep it. The next is Heavy Seas 20-Year Storm. Heavy Seas is a local brewery that I've always enjoyed. That's a pretty good beer. I really enjoyed that one as well, but that's another case of just, I'm a big fan of Heavy Seas and they're local, so they released a beer that's sort of hard to come by, so I kept the bottle. The next, Founders Canadian Breakfast Stout, is one that I really do enjoy and one I spent a lot of time trying to track down. Their regular breakfast stout's one of my favorite beers and something whenever I find it, I buy lots of. So the Canadian, you know, is one that's released only sporadically and one that the second I saw, I wanted to get. Absolutely fantastic beer. I prefer it over the Kentucky breakfast stout, which instead of being maple aged is bourbon aged. But yeah, it's Canadian breakfast stout, fantastic. The next is a Belgian that I just got and honestly kept because I had bought it and shared it with some friends during a party a couple years back. It was a great beer, but I more just kept it because of, you know, the night that it sort of symbolizes than the beer itself being anything particularly special. But the next two, Pliny the Elder and Supplication, both by Russian River, are actually very renowned and incredibly good beers. Pliny being a double IPA and Supplication being a sour. I prefer Supplication because I'm not a big hops guy. You know, I tried Pliny. My friend brought these two back from Russian River in California. I tried Pliny and thought it was great, but I'm not really a big IPA fan. It was more just the experience of being able to try it. Supplication, I am a big sour fan, and that was absolutely fantastic, but getting a chance to try both was really great. The next four are all Firestone Walker beers, which is my favorite brewery out in SoCal. Or really Central Cal, I guess, if you want to consider it that. Helldorado is a, and actually all of these beers are barrel aged, which is something that Firestone Walker does really well. Helldorado is a blonde barley wine. I really enjoyed that, but my favorite beer next to it, which is both the 2013 and 2015 vintage, or Sukaba. Sukaba is a barrel aged barley wine, and it is one of the richest, tastiest, and just all-around fantastic beers you'll find. It's my favorite beer of all time. I try to get it every year when they release it, though it can be hard at times, but it's just, it's like almost like drinking brandy in a sense. It's so rich, it's so dense, it's just so absolutely delicious. It's one I highly recommend to anyone who hasn't tried already. also had Velvet Merkin, which is an oatmeal stout. It was a bit thin for my taste, but still really tasty. It just doesn't quite have, you know, the viscosity or the mouthfeel of something heavier like Parabola or Tsukaba. So I enjoyed it, but it's not my favorite Firestone beer. Got 6, 8, and 10 of the Trappist Roquefort beers, relatively common, all Belgians, but all really good. I wanted to try each of them, and they're all relatively well-known. And you got Courage Russian Imperial Stout, or Imperial Russian Stout, as it says here. Just the absolute epitome of a good, you know, Russian Imperial. Nothing particularly fancy about it, but just does what it says it's going to do really, really well. Just tasty. Just, you know, what I think of when I think of a Russian Imperial done perfectly. And you got Bourbon County, two different vintages of the Bourbon County Brand Stout and the Bourbon County Browned Barley Wine, both of which are almost as good as Firestone Walker's Bourbon Barrel Aged stuff, Parabola and Tsukaba. Not quite as good, but really, really delicious. I highly recommend those. Hiding back here, we have two more Firestone Walker beers. Excuse me. Velvet Merlin, which is another oatmeal stout by them. You know, Velvet Merkin's a bit rare, and I prefer it. But my comments are kind of the same as they are with Velvet Merkin. And then Breda Rosé, which is a wild ale, has a nice sour sort of tangy taste to it. My friend got this out in California for me. Another delicious one, and kind of proves that Firestone can do no wrong in my eyes. So these beers, like I said, this isn't my top 10, top 20 or whatever, but some of these are definitely on my list. And in general, they're all beers that I either love or have some special significance to me. You'll see I kept the actual packaging on a couple. So yeah, incredibly stoked to get a Dark Lord Day. A bottle of Dark Lord will be up here sometime soon. And yeah, I just wanted to express that I am incredibly pumped to finally be making it out to Three Floyds for that. Looking forward to it.